numbers were a theme for Mission Impossible. And the last number that we just played for you featured our trumpet section. That was a Leroy Anderson original composition entitled Bugler's Holiday. I'm sure you can tell why it was titled Bugler's Holiday. That was our wonderful trumpet section. Another round of applause for you. This next piece is a wonderful standard, jazz standard, that was made very famous by late trumpet legend Louis Armstrong. This is called A Wonderful World. Thank you. theme from Sesame Street. We're going to finish off the sixth grade portion of tonight's concert with arguably one of the most popular TV franchises of recent memory. These kids have really enjoyed this song ever since the day we passed it out. I would like to take this opportunity, any of you parents of sixth grade band students, the level of excellence that they have achieved in this 1 year in sixth grade has been phenomenal. Typically, our repertoire consists of four songs. We like to challenge these kids with four pieces of music for each semester. But about 3 weeks ago, I thought, man, we're getting really stale and bored with these four tunes. We need to ramp it up a little bit. They've been doing such a wonderful job, and that's when we passed out Mission Impossible. So they really put their thinking caps on and worked really hard to prepare that in such a short amount of time. This last piece is probably their most difficult. They've been working extremely hard on this, and we hope you enjoy the theme from Game of Thrones. In between the groups, please feel free to stand, stretch your legs out as we fix up the stage for the 7th and 8th grade group. We'll do as quickly as possible. But please, I know sitting in these seats for a long period of time isn't so much fun. So please feel free to stand up, stretch those legs out. I hope so far you've enjoyed the 6th grade band here as we go.
Thank you.
side. You guys, over here. Thank you. Thank you.
flies in the back of my head, so I'm not sure if my daughter was back there dancing like crazy or not.
Yeah,
I'm giving the nod.
Yes, she was. All right. This next number we're going to do was kind of an anthem for last year. It's kind of like an unofficial anthem for the Penguins. This is, yeah, let's go Penguins. This was last year's unofficial anthem for the Penguins. This is Fallout Boy's Centuries.
Let's go on.
The next number we'd like to do for you tonight, we'll go from Fallout Boy, and we're going to go take it back a couple of decades, and this is a medley called The King of Pop. Thank you. Just last week, the 7th and 8th grade band traveled to Carnegie Mellon University to participate in the Heinen Music Festival. We performed two pieces for them down there. One was Centuries. The next is going to be our final piece of the night. The band was awarded the rank of excellence on their trip down there. And then spent the rest of the night. Yeah. Spent the rest of the day at Kennywood, riding all the rides and hanging out, having a good time. The kids deserve it. They've worked extremely hard. The pieces that we're playing tonight are very challenging, some of the more challenging pieces that I've given to the 7th and 8th ensemble. A lot of these numbers you're noticing from the previous group, 6th grade, tunes like a minute and a half, 2 minutes long. These average between 4 and 4.5 minutes in length, and that's a lot of music to learn. A lot of the numbers that we've done on Aladdin had 3 pieces in 1. King of Pop had 3 pieces in 1. This last one is no different. Some of the parents and maybe even the grandparents out here will, I think, will really appreciate this last one. This is entitled The Wild Westerns, and we're going to hear a little bit of Magnificent Seven, How the West Was Won, and one of my favorites, Silverado. Here's Wild Westerns.
Thank you.
most of the audience, the first tune requires no real introduction, but just in case, that was the ending from Disney's The Lion King. The second number we performed for you was done a few years ago. I believe it was an Oscar award-winning score from the film Lincoln. It was done by John Williams. We're going to change pace quite a bit, even more drastic, I think, from Lion King to Lincoln. We're going to go from Lincoln to some Earth, Wind, and Fire. And here is second.
Thank you.
just like the 7th and 8th grade ensemble, we took the high school symphonic band to a Pennsylvania Music Educators Association music performance assessment. We took them to an adjudication. Panel of judges listened, gave them critique, gave them a score and a rating, and they played very well. We're going to perform our next two numbers, or the two numbers that we did for the adjudication. The first may not be necessarily considered pop music. I mean, you could think of it that way if you put yourself back in like 17th, 18th century Ireland. The tune itself may be familiar to some of you. It's entitled Loch Lomond, which is an Irish folk song. And towards the end of this arrangement, you're going to hear layered in. I think that the terminology now is a mashup. So they take two songs and share the same chord progression and they put it together. This composer does it with a little more class than like Katy Perry or something like that. But this is Frank Tekeli's Loch Lomond. You're going to hear a little bit of Danny Boy. Here's Loch Lomond.
Thank you.
was the soundtrack done by James Horner, the late James Horner, for The Mask of Zorro. This next number we'd like to do for you is another Disney tune, but this is early to mid 80s. This is from An American Tale, and this is titled Somewhere Out There. Bridge. and bass clarinet, Ben Stewart. On trumpet, Bart Matthews. On French horn, Helen Kanitis. Tuba, Matt Horsick. And in the percussion section, we have Josh Bechtold. Seniors of the
Hi, everybody. I'm Brendan Bridge, and on behalf of the senior class, it's a great honor knowing this man. We were his first seventh grade group. He's helped us do a lot. We've been with him for jazz band, marching band, concert band, and for some of us even track. He's been with us for a while now, and we want to show our appreciation for you.
And I know they and I appreciate it very much. And so we wanted to offer you guys a taste of what the future holds for the band program. Here is a wonderful another medley. This is the Marches of John Williams.